Welcome. In this video, I will introduce you to the supply chain planning matrix. This is a conceptual framework which is commonly used to describe the main planning activities in supply chain management. The supply chain matrix classifies important supply chain planning activities based on aggregation level and planning intervals. Planning intervals can range from aggregated long-term to detailed short-term. Supply chain management is driven by demand. Consequently, demand planning is an important activity in supply chain management. Demand planning extends regular demand forecasting by accounting for exceptional influences that are expected to happen in the future. Examples of such influence are promotional campaigns, new policies, the introduction of new products, or even upcoming global events like a football World Cup. A very important long-term planning activity in supply chain management is strategic network planning. Here, it is very common to assume a planning interval of several years, since we focus on designing the structure of the supply chain. We make decisions related to the location and capacities of production sites, processing facilities, and warehouses. Often, strategic network planning involves decisions related to means of transportation and geographical areas of customers. Another very important activity is the master planning of the supply chain. It involves medium-term planning decisions and focuses on finding the most efficient way to fulfill the demand. The goal is to balance the demand forecast with available capacities and to assign demands to specific sites in order to avoid bottlenecks. The medium-term planning horizon allows for adjustments on the available resources and capacities. Master planning also accounts for restrictions of the procurement, since some raw materials may become a bottleneck for the whole supply chain. While master planning coordinates flows between sites, production planning and detailed scheduling take place within each site or production unit. Production planning activities are guided by decisions of the master planning. In production planning, the shifts, the machinery group, and the flow lines are decided. Here, bottlenecks are identified and potential solutions are found. In case the sequence of machinery and lot size decisions are sequential, both production planning and detailed scheduling are performed simultaneously. Master planning, as well as short-term production planning, provides directions for deciding upon procurement quantities. These decisions are part of the purchasing and material requirement planning. Such planning activities are very important in the biomass supply chains, since they are very much related to the availability and supply of biomass. So far, we have mainly concentrated on production operations. In distribution planning, the focus is on the flow of goods between sites and the structure of the distribution network. Seasonal stock levels have already been planned as part of the master planning. Here we have to take care of transport of bio-based products to customers or the collection of biomass from producers. In case production amounts do not match the demand, rules and procedures are applied to guide the flow of goods within the supply chain. The truckloads and routes have to be decided based on the production orders. This also requires detailed knowledge of orders from warehouses, distribution centers, and customers. Here, the specific needs of customers, like time windows for delivery and legal restrictions for drivers, are also taken into account. The interface of supply chain management to customers is the demand fulfillment and available to promise component of the supply chain matrix. Here, we track customers' orders from order entry via order execution to order delivery. Order promising, due date setting, and shortage planning are also considered. Order promising starts with matching available inventory and expected supplies with already committed customer orders. Remaining quantities are the available to promise quantities that can be used for promising due dates for new incoming orders. Now you know how the supply chain matrix can be used to describe the main planning activities in supply chain management. Thank you very much for watching.